Flip-flop, flip-flop, voila, voila, voila. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's absolutely fantastic to see everybody here. What a buzz. This is really lovely. I hope you have as good an evening as I know we're going to have. That was Klein Zack, a wonderful reminiscence of our production of The Tales of Hoffmann that we did last September. And we played in the Baxter Theatre opposite. It caused such a stir, people are still praising it. And two of the cast have been nominated for Fleur de Cap Theatre Awards. So we're very happy. This programme is relatively short. It's full of opera, a lot of which is very popular. It will include up to 34 singers, I think, which is about half our number. And we're not going to introduce everything. The programmes say most of what needs to be said. I will simply chat to us later on a little bit about our plans, just hints quite often, not always all the details. Meanwhile, I just need to remind you to keep your cell phones on silent and refrain from recording. Thank you very much.
Meine Ehre, ihr von mir wie ein Tier. Amore, amore, mai la vita, amore. tempo sia vero, prima che un giorno interno sia trascorso. Beva sì.
Sente
output as an independent performing entity. The year before, very important new work, Sarah Bartman by Hendrik Hofmeyr, was staged here at the Baxter Theatre by Janice Hanneman. And last year, we mounted in our own right Rossini's L'Inganno Felice at St. Eustaphius, and as I've already mentioned, The Tales of Hoffmann here. During both those years, we also had the huge pleasure of mounting collaboration productions with Cape Town Opera, in 2022, Alcina, and in 2023, Traviata. This coming year, the centerpiece of our fully staged performances is a world premiere staging of an opera by Donizetti. Just let that sink in for a second. Donizetti, who wrote his operas between, well, in the 1820s, 30s, and a few in the 1840s, we are giving the fully staged world premiere of one of his operas. The story goes like this. Composers in those days, not just Donizetti, even through to Verdi, had immense problems with the censors. Opera was intensely political, social, and the censors would block things at a moment's notice. And the piece Lucrezia Borgia that he had just written had problems with the censors. Luckily, that's now in circulation and everybody does it. And so what he did was he tried to write a new version of it using a lot of the music, but with differences to a completely different libretto called Dalinda. Well, that also caught the censors. They didn't approve it as it happened, and they wanted it to be changed. Meanwhile, as he's sitting there with all these problems, he gets a commission from Paris, and off he goes to Paris, and he does some other things, and Dalinda never gets staged. And not only that, but all his manuscripts get lost. So it's been one of those pieces which has been in the history books, and nobody ever knew where it was. And lo and behold, about a decade ago, maybe a little less, the manuscripts were found in the basement of some, I don't know whether it was the theatre or the conservatoire in Naples. A very exciting time, and the great Italian publishing house Ricordi, who published all the great Italian operas, and now with incredibly forensic critical editions, they have been working on this, and it is now ready. There's a company that deals with opera collaborations in Europe that has the rights to this for 3 years, and we were very lucky to be one of the companies that they chose to do it around the world. And I was very happy just to be one of the companies. I mean, why did we do that? However, I never dreamed we would give the premiere. So far, there has been one concert performance in Berlin, so not staged, one concert performance in Berlin last year, and we are giving the first staging in September of this year. So we're very, very excited. It's very much an international project. The eyes of the opera world will be on it, and we are delighted to be presenting this piece for the first time. Before this, because that's the sort of centerpiece of the middle of our year, we've decided to do something a little different. And instead of putting on an opera, we've decided to put together an evening which we're calling The Sound of Freedom. This year, almost 50% of the world's population is going to the electoral polls. It's 65 countries plus the European Union, I think. I mean, it's something extraordinary. I don't think this really happens very often. And we thought we would very much like to investigate composers' responses to freedom and democracy and so forth in the past, particularly because it was such a big deal in 19th century Italy. Verdi himself was, for a short time, a politician, and the letters of his name were even co-opted by the government and by the public as a slogan for independence and the establishment of a new Italian state and so forth. So we thought we would look at the history of that idea within opera, and to begin with, that will be a concert on this very stage with the UCT Symphony Orchestra and a whole variety of records. The very end of our year, I don't want to give too much away yet, but it will be another full staging, and we are delighted to have not only our partnership in Europe, which is producing the Donizetti Dalinda, but a new partnership with the Royal Opera House Covent Garden, and they are sending us a young, trained by them, conductor and director to take over our project, which we are incredibly excited about. We will update you with more, but I can at least entice you with that, and it will also be here at the back. These are the three cornerstones of our offer to the art scene of Cape Town. But we populate those cornerstones with a lot of other things. As usual, we run a variety of public competitions. And when I say public competitions, what I mean by that is first rounds tend to be very much in-house, but the finals are always big events in here. We have, coming up very soon, the Fokto competition. They are very generous in supporting opera in Cape Town, and particularly the young singers, many of whom are with us. Later in the year, there will be, for example, the David Aldred competition, which focuses on the Strauss Four Last Songs, a particular in her passion of his, so that's just for sopranos. And it will be now the third year of the Aviva Pelham Operetta competition. This is a very special event in our calendar. Operetta was at one stage regularly performed in Cape Town, regularly performed out throughout the world. It still is in certain areas of the world. It's such a shame that we don't do more here. But the reason we decided to institute a competition and to bring it back is because the one place it is still performed with great regularity is Germany. Most opera companies there will program an operetta at least per year. With 80 opera companies in the country, you can see that's quite a lot of repertoire. And because there are 80 companies in Germany, you can imagine many of our alumni find work there. So we thought, well, if they have no experience of operetta, they're going to find themselves struggling with that aspect. So we have instituted it. Aviva Pelham must be the South African expert on operetta. And so the stars aligned, and I very much hope that you will be able to join us for that later in the year. All the dates are in the program, of course. And we have a special addition to the repertoire this year. I don't know how many of you engaged with the Operalia competition when it was here. The Operalia competition, of course, run by, but conceived by, the great Plácido Domingo from Spain, he always includes Zarzuela. Zarzuela is the Spanish operetta, and so we thought, well, why not include some Zarzuela in our operetta competition as well? So if you enjoyed the Zarzuela at Operalia, you will be bound to hear more on our competition too. There are other competitions too, which you will also see lined up in the program. Another new venture of ours is a distinguished alumni concert series. We're so aware that our alumni, so many of them go to fantastic placements abroad, and they have very distinguished careers abroad. And it's not that they don't want to come back, it's not that they don't miss home, but you know, agents get hold of them and their careers run, and they quite often find it very difficult to come back. Or they pop back quickly for a few weeks to visit family and they're off again. So we said to them, please, if you are interested in doing recitals, they're obviously doing recitals in Europe, please come and be part of our series. We will support you as much as we can and publicize you as much as we can, because everybody will love to hear them. So this is a new venture of ours. Makudu Senawana is coming in a few weeks' time, and we'll be doing a recital with Dr. Lisa Engelbrecht, my partner in crime at the piano this evening. And we have various others. Musa Punwana is coming, Tandom Jandana is coming, and there are others. This will be very special because we hear them at the height of their powers, in the middle of their international careers. As usual, we also run public masterclasses. We have people coming to give residences, to give of their time, sometimes South African, sometimes people from Europe or America who are just in love with what we produce here and want to come and share. So in a few weeks' time, Sarah Jane Davies, who's a British singer who is also the head of casting at Scottish Opera and runs the Young Artists Programme at Les Azuriales in France, she will be here to talk to our singers and to give a public masterclass. Our principal guest coach will be coming for the third year running, Janet Haney. She is an incredible coach and teacher, working with singers all around the world. Many singers get in touch with her and say, I've got this opera coming up in Berlin, or I've got this opera coming up in Vienna, can I prepare it with you, please? So she adores South Africa. She will come as often as I ask her, and she will be here to work with 15 singers only, but 4 separate hours, 4 universities. It goes in 4 cycles, and then a public masterclass with many of them. And the wonderful distinguished South African mezzo-soprano Michelle Preet is also coming. She has had the most extraordinary career, appearing all over the world, but particularly associated with her singing of Wagner in Bayreuth. She gave the most fantastic masterclass. We had a weekend residency masterclass at Diemersfontein 2 years ago. And I have to say, these were the most incredible masterclasses I've ever seen. Yes, we sometimes look online and we see these great singers from the world giving masterclasses. This was very special, and we're very happy to see her back in this building. It will be here. Every year now, we also do a collaboration with the vocal department at Stellenbosch, and we're very, very happy to have instituted that in recent years. It always amazed me that it hadn't happened before. And this year, maybe there's a theme going on here, I haven't quite thought of this, we're going to focus on Spanish song, but not zarzuela, Spanish art song. There will be about a dozen Stellenbosch singers and about a dozen of ours, and we will be presenting songs from the repertoire. One, it's fantastic repertoire, it's just got such character and such spice to it, but of course we're also introducing them to the Spanish language, which is always very helpful, in addition to the constant work they do in Italian, French, and German. And lastly, an additional new initiative that we are undertaking this year, and that is book launches. After all, yes, we're an outward-facing performance company, but we are also part of a university, and we are very, very proud of our academic place in the opera world. So there are three books at the moment, and I think others also, other authors who are interested in coming and maybe allowing us to launch their books. The first will be Wayne Muller's book on the history of opera in Cape Town, particularly as seen through the critics and the reviewers. It's a very erudite book, full of fascinating information. And I think as he goes through his book, he's fascinated to be able to talk about a vision for 21st century opera in South Africa. Together with that, a book written by three very distinguished authors about Gordon Jeffters. Gordon Jeffters was a pianist and coach and repetiteur of the Eon Group long before he was allowed to join the mainstream in this country. And he had the extraordinary good fortune to be able to go to Europe. He worked with some of the greatest singers, your Domingos, your Pavarottis, your Cavaliers. And so this is the story of him. And lastly, a feel-good book by Margriet Stemmet called South African Envoys of Opera, really charting all the South African singers over quite a long time who have had careers abroad and have been envoys of South Africa. So we're delighted to be able to share all this with you. You have some of it in your programs. Please stay in touch with us. Please sign up to our mailing list. And please come and support and come and be entertained and inspired by us throughout the year. Thank you very much.
Sappia vos, acqua mia voi.
io saprum già e verranno Filippo e la regina
Elisabetta
in franca incantuare lo spirito che vacilla serena ancora la stella tua e al cieli brilla o manda al ciel e forti la virtù.
So just two more items. Having said earlier, please put your phones away and all that sort of stuff. This is your chance to take them out. Switch them on, feel free to take photos, whatever, and please post on social media and don't forget to tag us. See you later.
Thank you. Drink to the Lord of Pleasure, don't drink to the world champagne.